I genuinely think the New England Patriots could surprise some people this year. And I think they might have one of the most overly hated on players in the entire NFL. But I'll tell you why I think that and who that is in just a second. But super, super quick, massive shout out to Goose for the suggestion of today's video. Go drop them a sub, their link is in the description. And if you want a shout out just like that one, it's super easy. All you gotta do is let me know what team to do next. And then of course, when I eventually pick your comment, I'll give you a shout out, tell everyone to sub to you, all that good stuff, and it helps me know what y'all want to see. So it's a big win-win. But we've been doing very, very well with all the like goals lately. Let's see if we can get to 500 on this one. And if we can hit that, I'll have another fantasy draft style rebuild coming up soon. And actually, I might do it for 7,500 subs, but I have a special different type of rebuild that I think y'all would really enjoy. So once we hit 7,500 subs, I'll do that. I appreciate all the new subscribers and the old ones. So if you want to be an OG of the channel while you still can be one, be sure to subscribe, because if you like rebuilds, you're definitely in the right place, because that's literally all I do. And also turn on notifications for the channel if you want to be one of the first ever people to see and comment on my videos. But again, 500 likes and I'll have another fantasy draft rebuild out on Sunday. But that's enough plugging. Of course, get a drink, get a snack, get whatever. And let me tell you what I think about this Patriots team. So last year was obviously not very good. They massively underperformed, and not only does it look like the Patriots dynasty is over, but it looks like they're not even really that good of a team at all anymore. But I think there was a very obvious reason for that, and a reason that made me question if Bill Belichick is going senile a little bit. I think the main problem of this team was that they had Matt Patricia, who wasn't even a good defensive coordinator. I mean, he was a fine defensive coordinator. They had him try to be an offensive coordinator for God knows what reason, and that went about as well as you would expect. I mean, it resulted in, like, Mac Jones screaming and crying and pissing his pants on the sideline, which was for good reason. Like, that was a goddamn awful offense. And speaking of Mac Jones, it seems like people are just kind of out on him because of this last season, but I mean, removed from Matt Patricia, he was really good in his rookie year, and I don't think it was a coincidence what happened last year. So I do expect at least a bounce back from him. I do expect him to be better. I feel like he is really overhated right now because lol, goofy, he fat, he walked weird at the goddamn draft. I don't know. It bothers me when people correlate goofy shit off the field to players on the field, if that makes any sense. Like, I mean, Mac Jones wasn't good last year, don't get me wrong, but I feel like that was for good reason. And not to mention, this offense added some pretty good pieces. I mean, Juju Smith-Schuster, this receiving core is slow as hell outside of Tyquan Thornton. Like, I think that could be a problem. But I did like the signing of Mike Gesicki. Riley Reiff is a decent band-aid. I always think of Riley Reed when I think of him, which is really cool. I love that. And then on defense, I'll obviously have to give Christian Gonzalez a dev trait. I think I'm gonna go superstar because I do really like him. But yeah, I thought that was a steal at like 17 or wherever they got him. I don't know how he fell that far. I don't know what we're gonna do with Jack Jones. Like, he was good as a rookie, but now he's in trouble, like gun trouble, after like yelling at John Morant over it. Like, okay, dude. Also apparently had character concerns at USC, which I didn't even know he was at USC. And that's why he got like either kicked out of there, or I don't know. I guess we'll play him because he isn't like off the team or anything, but I don't know. They have Keon White, which he's meh. I'm not a super big fan, but I might give him like star dev or something just because he was a high pick. They have Kayshon Booty, who could theoretically turn into like a monster. Just, I guess, another character concern guy, which it's surprising that the Patriots have gone so many character concern guys. I think Ramondre Stevenson was, who, and Juju at one point, not like legally, but just TikTok and shit. I don't know. Either way, I like what this team has. I like this defense. I do expect maybe a Christian Barmore breakout in real life this year too. The offense, I don't know if it'll be great by any means in real life, but I think it will be better than last year, which isn't hard to do. But I think Bill O'Brien, he's kind of a meme because he destroyed the Texans, but he's not going to be the GM here. They they might have an equally bad GM in Bill Belichick, but no, he's better than Bill O'Brien was. Either way, fuck Bill Belichick. We have Mikey McDingle here, the absolute GOAT. So with that, enough rambling about this Patriots team. I'll give the players dev traits and all that, at least the rookies. So with that, let's get into the rebuild. Let's see if there are any scenarios, but if not, I'll just see y'all at the midseason point of year number one. Okay, well, we have a wide receiver mentorship, Devontae Parker to Tyquan Thornton. I guess we'll go getting open. I was thinking about giving Tyquan Thornton a dev trait, but I was like, I just want to do the rookies. I don't want to cheese it too much. Although I think Thornton might deserve it because he probably will develop a decent amount if he does get on the field. I mean, he's really athletic, obviously. I think he, like, people thought he broke the 40 time record, but the official time came in and it was a lot lower. But either way, he's really fast, so I don't know, he gets an upgrade there. And we have a camp standout for Christian Barmore. Let's go rushing the passer. So +3 power moves, +3 finesse moves, and he had an upgrade this last week, so I think he'll be good in real life, but he could also be really good here too. We'll see. Okay, so at the midseason point of year number one, we are 3-4. Not terrible, but I was hoping we would be a lot better. I'm not gonna lie. I guess we don't have the greatest team in the world. We're only an 80 overall, but I was hoping for better things. But I guess it's only year one anyways. God, do I want to bother with getting the realistic contracts? I'm gonna have to do that. God damn it, give me a second. More like an hour. Okay, I got the contracts updated. Is this team actually like this screwed for re-signings? It's set to be 1, 2, 3, 4, I guess 5, not really 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 like high level starters, 10 starters if you include Riley Reiff. Yikes. Well, Mike Ngwenu, we definitely want him back. One of the more underrated guards in the NFL. We'll go, he might accept this 5 years, 61.5 mil. He does. Mike Gesicki, he's our number one tight end. I definitely want him back. The Patriots definitely love their versatile players, and he is definitely one. Can be a receiver, a slot receiver, can be a tight end. Really good athlete. Let's offer him 4 years, 46.4 mil. That's a lot steeper than he would get in real life, but, and he doesn't take it. 4 years isn't a long-term commitment. I mean, maybe we'll just stick with Mark Andrews, Hunter Henry then. I wish we could stick with Mark Andrews. Goddamn. Kyle Duggar, we might have to go player friendly. Or here, I'll just offer 6 years, 61.8 mil. That's a long contract for an already 26-year-old player, but we'll see if he takes that. And he does. Juwan Bentley, I definitely want him back to 4 years, 33.2 mil. He resigns. And then Hunter Henry, I would rather pay a little more for Mike Gesicki than just go with Hunter Henry, because Mike Gesicki could still develop more. A year younger, 3 overall better. But how's Trent Brown doing this year? Let's check. 5 sacks allowed so far. He doesn't normally do very well in this game. So maybe we'll wait. Kendrick Bourne is our third receiver, so I don't want to have to pay 3 receivers. Well, I guess 2 of our 3 receivers are here. Josh Uche, I definitely want him back. We'll probably have to go very player friendly. The problem is he's not a very good scheme fit. I mean, in real life he is, but our rush defensive ends are both power and he's more of a speed guy, so he doesn't really fit that. We'll go player friendly, 5 years, 45 mil, but I highly doubt he accepts that. He doesn't. And I guess we will resign. We'll try to resign Kendrick Bourne, even though he's not all that interested. We might just look to upgrade there, actually. I like him in real life, but we could get a better number 2 receiver, pretty much, for a comparable price. So I think we'll wait on the rest of the players here. We are set to have a good amount of money, though, so that's a positive. But with that, let's just simulate it to the end of the year, and let's see how this team can finish. All right, well, at the end of year number one, we finish 8-9. This whole division was, like, right around 500. Us and the Jets were 8-9, the Dolphins 9-8, and the Bills were actually good at 11-6. But let's check out some of the season stats this year. Mac Jones with 4,600 yards, 34 touchdowns, 13 picks. That would be a really good season for real life. That's a solid season for Madden. They need to lower their, like, passing numbers, or just numbers in general. Because, yeah, Matthew Stafford had 53 passing touchdowns. Yeah, they need to cool it off a little bit. Because Mac Jones with 34 passing touchdowns was just mid. If you have 34 in real life, that's probably, like, top 3 in the NFL. So, I don't know. That's interesting. Ramondre Stevenson was, he had 1,100 yards, but only 3.9 yards per carry. 9 touchdowns. Mike Gesicki Gesicki with almost 1,200 yards and 10 touchdowns. He was our leading receiver. Kendrick Bourne with 1,000 yards, 12 touchdowns. Juju, 900. Devontae Parker, 800 yards. Blocking, Riley Reiff was horrific, but everyone else, by a Madden standpoint, was pretty good. Juwan Bentley led the team with 113 tackles. Tackles for loss. Tackles for loss, 15 for Matt Judon. That led the team. And then sacks, only 8.5 for Matt Judon. And then, like, nothing outside of that. 5.5 for Dietrich Wise. I feel like sack numbers are never right. They're either way too low or way too high. But then interceptions, we had like fucking 7 total. 2 for Tavai and Jones, and then 1 for a few players. This was a weird team. MVP goes to Matthew Stafford. I don't think I've ever seen that before. Cooper Kupp up there for MVP. I gotta see what he did. He probably had 3,000 yards. I absolutely despise this game. Oh my god. Who tested? Do they even test franchise? Do they test simulation? In what fucking world does a receiver get almost 2,400 yards and 30 touchdowns? I love how two of the top 5 receivers in the NFL are Robert Woods and Sterling Shepard and Curtis Samuel up there. This game is great. Well, offensive player of the year goes to Nicholas Chubb. Ooh, Kareem Hunt signed back with the Chiefs, it looks like. That's kind of fun. I don't see any Patriots up here. Defensive player of the year goes to Max Crosby. No Patriots. Am I in the right conference? I think so. Offensive rookie of the year goes to CJ Stroud. No Patriots. And then defensive rookie of the year goes to Trent McDuffie. Not a rookie. It goes to Will Anderson. Christian Gonzalez at number, I guess, 4. Jack Jones up there, but again, not a rookie anymore. So not a bad first season. I'm glad to know we can be at least decent. We had the best defensive pass yards per game in the NFL. Apparently our pass defense was really good, which makes sense. I mean, we have a good and really deep safety group. We have a good pass rush. It didn't play that well, but it is pretty good in real life. Christian Gonzalez is good. Marcus Jones is good. Wait, am I saying the right name? Do they have 2 Marcus Jones? No, I don't think they do. There's Jonathan Jones. That's who I was thinking of. Never mind. There's too many Jones on this. I'm gonna get confused so many times. I mean, there's Jonathan Jones, Jack Jones, Marcus Jones, all cornerback. Obviously, Mac Daddy, Mac Griddle, Mac Jones. There are probably more in real life. I probably just hud them. I don't know. Whoever fucking Bill Belichick just apparently hates seeing people mess up names. I don't know. Ah, well, you hate to see that. The 49ers beat the Chiefs 31-21. Ah, you thought the Eagles-Chiefs Super Bowl was loud. Get ready for that one. Staying off of fucking Twitter for months after that. You know what? Maybe I just like to play devil's advocate or something, but I don't think Eagles fans are that bad. I think they're annoying sometimes, but there are certain fan bases that are just like terrible people, I'm convinced. I'm not gonna say exactly who, but I'm sure if you've seen my videos before, you probably know my opinion on that. But in terms of re-signings, oh, we of course have to re-sign Mike Gesicki. How could I forget? I guess we'll have to offer him player friendly, 5 years, 67.5 mil. He re-signs. That's a lot of money, but he was good last year. He was our leading receiver. Trent Brown, I feel like he only played well because he needs a contract. We will find a different option, because if he was interested, then sure, but I just don't trust him. I've seen him do horribly in this game before, and he's already 30, and he kind of looks like a fat kid. That's mean, I'm sorry. He could probably beat my ass at 6'8", 380. He could turn me into a nice tomato soup with a grilled cheese with the snap of his fingers. Like, I shouldn't talk shit, but Josh Uche, here's the thing. You know what? I don't know if I should. He just doesn't work with our scheme. He's not like that expensive though. We'll offer him 5 years, 47.5 mil. If he takes it, cool. He does. He's a good player in real life, don't get me wrong, but here he just doesn't work super well, but we will re-sign him. I did re-sign. And then the two receivers, kind of mid, we can find upgrades. So with that, let's get into free agency and let's hopefully upgrade this team. Ooh, wait, did the Raiders tag Josh Jacobs or extend him in real life? I can't remember. Okay, interesting. He is just on the tag in real life, so it is realistic for him to be here. I'm down. Ah, well, he is too big off for. Okay, well, we'll see what we can do here. Hopefully we can add some good players. Okay, well, we're gonna go for 2 potentially really big difference makers. It's gonna be Josh Jacobs and Jadeveon Clowney. Jadeveon Clowney isn't like amazing in real life, obviously, but he's kind of a monster in Madden simulation most of the time. The Raiders are competing for both of the players we're going for. The Commanders are also very interested in Josh Jacobs, which I could see for some reason. I don't know why, but 2 really big difference makers here potentially. Let's see if either of either of these two do sign. They both sign, and we get Josh Jacobs. Okay, cool. No Jadeveon Clowney. He probably goes to the Raiders. Yeah, he went to the Raiders. That's fine. And actually, I want to see if we can re-sign Kendrick Bourne on just a one-year deal. I don't know if he'll want to, but I want to eventually upgrade, but we kind of just need a Band-Aid starter right now. Well, we do have Tyquan Thornton if we don't draft an upgrade. You know what? Next year can be kind of a rebuilding year. This team isn't too old anyways. Well, I guess some of it is, but like, I'm fine with a potential rebuild year. We're gonna need tackles, and that's what I'm gonna prioritize in the draft. So receiver might be kind of an afterthought. And then on defense, I can just move Barmore to defensive tackle and play Keon White on the other side, so that works out. We don't really need a defensive lineman. I was thinking maybe Ed, but it just plays Dietrich Wise there anyways, and that's what they do pretty much. So I think we're good here, so let's get to the draft. All right, well, here in the draft, we have the number 14 overall pick. The Titans had the number one pick, which might be doing a video with them soon. We'll see. But I think I know what position I want to go with. I just don't know the player. Let's see. Why are there so many first round tackles, and why do they all look like it? Yeah, that's what I want in my starting left tackle. 23 bench rep for a first round pick. Yeah, that's great. Honestly, all the tackles kind of look like shit. Keegan Ruff might be the best. He's 6'5", 313, 20. 21 years old, out of Oklahoma, 35 reps on the bench at the combine, 37 at his pro day. I mean, he had a good combine. Awareness, impact block, pass block finesse, but he probably also has good run block finesse. It's probably an A, but he's not really great at anything else. He has B run block, but only C pass block. He looked okay. I just like the strength. He has solid speed for a tackle. All of them don't look very good, so he looks like the best out of the shit. So let's take him. He has hidden dev. Okay, cool. He'll be our right tackle. We'll find a left tackle hopefully later, hopefully in the next round, but he looks like a pretty good player. And in the second round, there's still maybe some decent tackles available. I actually think AJ Vogel looks pretty good. Looks similar-ish to the last player. Really similar, actually. He's 6'6", 319, 21 years old, out of Miami. Very, very similar, actually. 37 and 35 reps. Those were the exact numbers the last guy had. All right, well, let's get the same player back-to-back. Also hidden dev. The last guy had 90 strength. I think this guy is 89. We took the same player twice. Cool. That worked. Here in the third round, I do want a receiver. Ooh, probably not that guy. Well, maybe. I thought this dude's name was Richard Nixon. He looks pretty good, though. I mean, the play rec is awful, but good speed, good strength. He's 5'11", 233, 22 years old. Obviously a linebacker out of Ole Miss. We do kind of need a third linebacker in an eventual replacement to one of the two we have. Let's take him. Normal dev, unfortunately, but really good speed, good strength. That could be a pretty good pick, even though he doesn't have a dev trait. We'll see. A deep threat with 4.52 speed? That's disgusting. He could actually... No, if he had good deep route, then he could be a really good player, maybe? I don't know. No thanks. I think I'm just gonna simulate the rest of this out, and let's see what the CPU can do. Actually, I lied. I took one player, and he actually looked pretty good. He had 99 speed. We'll see. Alright, well, here is a recap of the draft. Our first two picks were really good. Keegan Ruff is a 74 overall. He is going to be our right tackle, playing with plus 4 strength for some reason, but really good finesse blocker. Not the best pass blocker, though, which is a little confusing, but it is what it is. And we will play the better overall player and the better pass blocker at left tackle in AJ Vogel at a 75 overall. That was kind of a steal in the second round, unless he allows like 20 sacks this year, which he probably will. But another good finesse player, a little bit better of a pass blocker, like I said. Also good strength. Both very similar. Richard Paxton's only a 70 overall. I thought he would be more like a 73. Look fine enough, though. I mean, it's not a bad pick in the third round at all. Dakota Witherspoon, the guy with 99 speed. He was projected to go in the first round, obviously fell, and it looks like that was for good reason, because he's only a 67 overall. I mean, he does have hidden dev, which is nice, but meh. Unless he has, like, superstar or something. We took a better receiver in the next round. This guy was a projected UDFA, 70 overall. And then I did actually take every pick here. Harper was okay, and then the last two picks were bad. It was a pretty good draft, honestly. I think all of them probably will make the team. All right, well, here's a look at the team heading into year number 2 of the rebuild. This is the weirdest team I've ever gone into year number 2 with. 2 rookie tackles, a really good running back, and like 0 receivers. This is a goddamn weird offense. We'll see if it plays well, but I don't have much hope. We'll see. Oh yeah, and I am gonna be starting, what the fuck is his name, Dakota Weatherspoon? It's not even Witherspoon, it's Weatherspoon. What are you fucking putting a spoon out like it's a flag or something? Like seeing which direction the wind is blowing? I don't know. I might have said that backwards. I meant spoon out like it's a flag. Did I say flag out like a spoon? Dude, I need to sleep more. Either way, we're gonna get him playing time. Maybe he has a good dev trait. I don't know. Here's the defense. Really not much has changed here. Just Keon White is gonna be starting instead of Lawrence Guy, I guess. And that is literally it. Everything else is the same. And we're putting Jabril Peppers at free safety, which don't know that I would do that in real life, but it's Madden, so we'll see how that goes. So with that, let's get to the midseason point of year number two, and let's see how this team can do. Okay, so at the midseason point of year number two, we are only 3-3. We're pretty much the same as last year. I mean, we were 3-4, so I guess we're technically better, but we're probably gonna lose this next game anyways. Things still aren't going amazing. Ooh, we have the worst defense in the NFL, yet are 6th in terms of rush yards per game allowed and 19th for pass yards per game allowed, but do we just have the worst red zone defense of all time? Maybe, but oh god, I'm gonna have to get all the fucking right contracts again. Well, no, these might be close enough. Jabril Peppers, Jonathan Jones, and that's like it. I can't wait for Madden 24 simply because I won't have to mess with the contracts and the draft picks so much. It's so annoying. I don't know why they don't just make them editable outside of franchise so you don't have to reset them in every franchise you go into. It's stupid. But do I want Jonathan Jones back? I guess so. He's a good player. He's already 29. That's the only problem, but he's good. We'll offer him 2 years, 17.4 mil. He takes it. And Jabril Peppers, I guess we don't really have any safeties anymore. We have Adrian Phillips, but he's old. So I guess Jabril Peppers is really only the only other option at safety. Other than, of course, Kyle Duggar, but I'm talking both of the starting safeties. You know what I mean. Maybe. I don't make much sense sometimes, but we'll offer him 3 years, 24 mil. Will we? Are we going to do that? Yeah, I guess so. Let's do it. Okay, cool. He takes it. And then everyone else here is just a bunch of backup. So I think we're good. I mean, our kicker and punter were there, but they both kind of suck. But with that, let's get to the end of year number two, and hopefully we can somehow, I guess, rebound and make the playoffs. We'll see. All right, well, y'all know why we're here. If you haven't already, 500 likes or whatever I set the goal as, just be sure to like the video. It helps out a ton, and it helps me know y'all are still enjoying these rebuilds. And I don't even think I set a sub goal. Let's shoot for 7,000. I was hella tired when I recorded the first part. I still am. Just to be sure to subscribe for more rebuilds. The channel's been growing like crazy lately. We're getting closer and closer to 10K. So thank you all so much for that. If you want to be an OG while you still can be one, be sure to subscribe, and of course turn on notifications too. And of course, if you want a shout out, just let me know what team to do next. It sounds like a lot, but it should take you like 30 seconds to do all of that, including the comment. I don't know. But here's a look at the team at the end of year number two. Actually, Weatherspoon has superstar dev, which is, I don't know how he made it out of the first round. I mean, the CPU can just kind of tell a lot of the time when a player will have a good dev trait, or at least they used to. Maybe it just doesn't anymore. I don't know if he's necessarily going to become great, because I don't know how much playing time he's going to get, but the superstar is very nice. Outside of that, Ruff and Vogel, the tackles, both have star, but that's what I expected, and I don't think we had any hidden on defense. But in year number two, we finished 9-8, but we made the playoffs. I don't know how, because we didn't even win the division. The Bills did at 10-7. Also, these are the identical records almost to last year. Just we were 8-9, the Dolphins were 9-8, and the Bills were 11-6, I think. So there are a total of 3 wins that are different. That's weird. Ooh, Mac Jones was not great this year. 4,300 yards, 22 touchdowns, 10 picks. Maybe he just isn't the guy. I've seen him do well on other teams, though. Like, sometimes the Steelers will take him in the fantasy drafts, and he'll do, like, really well. Oh my god. Josh Jacobs, almost 1,800 yards, 5.9 per carry, and 31 touchdowns. Is that a record? I'm pretty sure the record is like 27 or something. It's 28 set by LaDainian Tomlinson in 2006. So Josh Jacobs now has a record. That's interesting. Juju led the team with 1,000 yards, 7 touchdowns for him. Tyquan Thornton was good. Mike Gesicki was good. Dakota Weatherspoon as a rookie was also good. 869 yards. Nice. 6 touchdowns. We'll take that. Blocking. Ruff was bad. Vogel wasn't great. David Andrews wasn't great either. But both of our tackles were rookies. That's about what we would have to expect. Jelal Kalani Tavai actually led the team in tackles with 136. Tackles for loss, 13 for Judon led the team. And sack, really our only sack getter is Matt Judon, 11 for him. And then like nothing really outside of that. I do think I want to look for a better pass rusher. Josh Uche just isn't getting it done. And then interceptions, 3 for Duggar and Jones. And then, well, I gotta be more specific, Jonathan Jones. There are like 6 of them. And then 1 interception for a number of players. So I don't really know what the problem was this year. It looked like it was just Mac Jones and that was about it. And maybe we just didn't get enough pressure. Well, we made the playoffs. I'm talking like it was a terrible team. We had a winning record. It's just we weren't great. But Patrick Mahomes wins MVP here. Realistic top 3. Josh Jacobs at number 9. I think that's the first time I've ever had a non-QB for MVP, at least for the team I'm using. I mean, offensive player of the year obviously goes to Josh Jacobs. No other Patriots. Defensive player of the year goes to Max Crosby. No Patriots. Jadeveon Clowney up there. Would have been nice to get him, but oh well. Offensive rookie of the year goes to Stephon Tyson of the Tennessee Titans. No, I forgot. Dakota Weatherspoon at number 2. That sucked. God damn it. But Tyson might have been a QB. Well, I don't know if that's a normal QB fate. It might. I don't know. We'll check. No other Patriots, though. Defensive rookie of the year went to Tashaun Wynn of the 5-12 Baltimore Ravens. Okay, yeah. Stephon Tyson was a QB. He was decent for sure. Only normal dev, though. A lot of pick. Not a great completion percentage, but good amount of touchdowns. Good amount of yards. That was deserving for sure, but I still wish we could have won it. But we have a first of many here. Honestly, I don't expect us to go far anyways. Plus, just straight simulating games has worked much better than like jumping in and watching it simulate. So I don't think we're gonna jump in, but always gotta play it cool, you know me. So yeah, I think we're just gonna simulate this game out. We're gonna be taking on the 12-5 Cincinnati Bengals, which to be fair, they're an 84, and I think we went up to an 84 after the upgrade. Yeah, so we have the same overall team, but let's see what happens. Oh, we absolutely shit on them. 42-20. In Cincinnati with like the same level of team as them with a worse record. I don't know about that, but we'll take it. Upgrade for Weatherspoon. We'll definitely take that. And we're going to be taking on the Kansas City Chiefs in the divisional. We have a recap for the first of many. Give us those sweet and juicy staff points, please and thank you. And let's simulate this game out against the Chiefs and see if we can somehow win. I kind of hope we don't win this one. We are not a deserving team yet. Okay, we lose 28-21. That's valid. I am okay with that. We still have 2 more years to improve this team. It's crazy we're already an 84 in only year 2. I like what we're doing so far. The Chiefs do end up winning the Super Bowl though, 46-35 over the Dallas Cowboys. Let's just get the loudest fan bases in the Super Bowl every year. That's a really high scoring Super Bowl too. Only 1 upgrade for Josh Jacobs. That's kind of surprising, but we'll take it. Wearing number 18, ew. But +3 spin move and +2 juke just made him a lot shiftier. They put butter on his feet or something. I don't know. We'll take it. All right, well, we're getting a little wacky. We're getting a little silly, a little goofy in free agency. I didn't even show the re-signings because it was literally nothing there. I re-signed Colby Parkinson and that's all I did. Very underrated in real life. I think someday he will be a good starter, but just buried on the Seahawks right now. Either way, we're going for a massive free agent class here. It's gonna be, I'll just list them off. Rashawn Gary, Justin Herbert, DJ Reader, Michael Pittman, and Shaq Thompson. To get all of these players would make this a crazy team. The biggest one is obviously Justin Herbert. I think I'm ready to let go of Mac Jones. He just isn't working out here. I mean, the 2 seasons he had, in real life, those would be 2 pretty good seasons, but here it's just, we can do so much better. If we do get Justin Herbert, I'll find a trade partner. Maybe I'll trade him to the 49ers or something because they were apparently interested in him at one point, so I can't wait to see him win MVP on the 49ers. That'll be fun. But yeah, obviously we need another power rusher. Any D-line help is good D-line help. Michael Pittman, we don't really have a like number 1 receiver. We have Juju, but I would consider him closer to a number 3 than a number 1. Well, I guess he's more of a number 2, but still. And then we don't really need linebacker. Maybe we don't need to go for Shaq Thompson, but we're just going for as many upgrades as we can get. I mean, why not? Maybe corner would be better. We could go for Chidobe Awuzie. I get him in like every rebuild though, seems like. So I tried to go for some different players here. But without further ado, I mean, there isn't much else for me to say. Let's see if we can can get any of these players right off the bat. Okay, so everybody signs except for, interestingly enough, Rashawn Gary. But let's see, out of those players, who we got. So we get Justin, we get all four of them. Okay, that's kind of crazy. I'm gonna show what the team looks like now in a second, after we like see if we can get Rashawn Gary. I guess we'll just skip ahead again. And it looks like he does sign, he signs with us. This might be the biggest free agent class I've ever had in a rebuild. This was crazy. That completely overhauls this team pretty much. Yeah, Michael Pittman in here now, Justin Herbert. This offense is looking incredible. And then on defense, the duo of Matt Judon, who did get X Factor. I noticed it, I just didn't mention it for some reason. And then Rashawn Gary, that's a great duo. I'll move Barmore back out to defensive end. I think Keon White was pretty good though. So maybe I don't want to replace him, but Barmore is an overall upgrade, so I don't know. Let's see if Chidobe Awuzie is still there, because maybe we could bring him in. I mean, he would be an upgrade. He probably signed though. He was the number one corner available. He had interest, so I could almost guarantee that he already signed. Yeah, he signed with the Packers. Ooh, Bryce Hall is here with Superstar Dev. That's interesting. He had a lot of offers already though. So I think we're done in free agency for the year, but we literally got the top two players and three of the five biggest players. Four of the seven biggest, five of the eight biggest players are now on our team. That's crazy. Was it realistic? I don't know. But to be fair, the Patriots a couple years ago did go crazy in free agency. It didn't really work out for them, but I think I have more of a plan for these players than the Patriots did. And let's see if we can work out a trade for Mr. Mac Daddy, Mac Griddle. All right, well, the Raiders already have, I guess, Tom Brady as a part owner of the team, a former Patriot. They have Jimmy Garoppolo still there. I think they even have Brian Hoyer in real life, another former Patriot. They don't have Jarrett Stidham anymore, but they did last year. They just love their former Patriots QBs, apparently. So they're getting another one. They're getting Mac Jones. We're getting a second round pick. I think that's fair, because Mac Jones has been decent. He hasn't been terrible. It's just, we found an upgrade. We found a better option. So Mac Jones is now a Raider. I don't know how good of a fit that is, but we'll definitely take a second round pick. Isn't Jarrett Stidham on the Broncos now? Jarrett Stidham was legitimately good last year for the Raiders in the like three games he was in. I fucking loved him coming out of Auburn. I really thought he would be good, but I mean, there's still a chance. We'll see. Either way, amazing free agency over. So with that, let's get to the draft. Okay, so the Packers of all teams have the number one overall pick. Have they like ever had the number one overall pick? I'm sure they have at some point. They're a fucking old ass team. Aren't they like the third oldest team or something? Like the Bears and Cardinals are the first two? I'm probably really wrong about that, but either way, we have the number 25 overall pick. Let's see what we want to do here, because to be completely honest, we don't really have many needs that we can fill in the draft, if any. I mean, maybe a third receiver, but I like Weatherspoon. I want to try to develop him. But if there is a really good receiver here, I might have to do it. We could also go D-line, but I mean, we have Keon White as depth, and we have three good starters, DJ Reader being a really good starter. I don't think we can find a corner better than Jack Jones. Safety, we couldn't really upgrade there. O-line, I mean, we could find a higher overall player than Cole Strange, but he's been good, like really good. I felt like I was the only person that actually liked that pick when they made it. So I guess we will look at receiver. Ooh, another really, really fast guy. A 4.24 is only second? I need to find out who's first. Okay, this guy also ran a 4.24, but the third and fourth at the pro day, what the fuck? First is probably also just a 4.24, I'm guessing. I don't want to accidentally take one of these guys though in the first round, so I don't want to mess with that too much. Rashad Poole doesn't look that great, but he is a pure first round talent, so he's probably like a 74, 75 overall. He's pretty fast, just not a great looking receiver, to be honest. He has good deep route and release, but and spec catch, but that's like about it. God damn, who's this? Trent Hogan? This guy looks really good too. Damn, we don't need a tight end, but I guess we don't not need a number two tight end. I don't know. Okay, I'm intrigued that this Keegan Ashley guy, even considering how good of a deep threat he is, with 4.24 speed in a deep route, I'm intrigued by the fact that he's listed as a playmaker, not a deep threat. So that must mean he's like just a really good ball carrier, which I don't know that he is. His spin move isn't all that good, or his juke move, or his break tackle, but his ball carrier vision and carrying look good. He's either gonna be really good or like really bad. I don't know. Let's take the safer pick. Let's just go Rashad Poole. He's gonna have normal dev, I can almost guarantee, but he's pretty fast. Decent overall ratings.
size?
He's 5'11", 192, 23 years old, out of Ohio State. Let's take him. Normal dev. I knew it. God damn it. He'll be a good overall. We'll see. You know, corner depth wouldn't be too bad. Leo Grant? This guy actually looked good. Is there anyone better, though? Nah, I don't think so. Sometimes really good corners do fall out of the first round for some reason. I mean, I guess the same thing kind of happened in real life with Joey Porter. Christian Gonzalez fell to this team. Not out of the first round, but he fell. Didn't fall very far, but still. Leo Grant does look pretty good. He's 6'4", 184, 21 years old, out of Cal. Good speed, good ratings. He'll probably have D-man coverage, but we'll just go a million slot upgrades. It'll up his man a lot, so could be a starter next year. We'll see. Let's take him. Ooh, back-to-back normal dev. He only has 79 jumping. Ooh, got some weak-ass knees, apparently. Only 85 agility, too. How do you only have 85 agility? You're 6'1", 184. You're a damn near pencil. But I think he'll be a good overall player. We'll see. Ooh, there's some good-looking players still left. Wait, this guy looked good. What the fuck? These top two guys both look good. Keegan Ashley is still here. And this Tyrone May, or Tyron, it's two N's. Is that Tyrone May? His power's bad, but that's fine. Let's just take him. Another normal dev, but I feel like he'll be a good overall. We're striking out with the dev traits here, but I'm fine with it. I think we're getting decent overall players. That might be the slowest safety I've ever seen. I was like, a run support safety that actually has okay-ish man coverage? I was like, maybe he'll be good. And then I see 4.72. Fuck that. I'm simulating the rest of the draft out. Get me out of here. Okay, so overall, we had a really nice draft once again. Rashad Poole is exactly what I expected, a 75 overall. Really good speed, of course. Good spec catch, good deep route, good agility, good excel. I thought I said he was a playmaker, though, but he is a deep threat? Or was the other guy a... No, I think the other guy was a playmaker. Now I can't remember, but I think that's what it was. Leo Grant is a 73 overall, so he's also a good player. Will be our, I guess, fourth corner, maybe fifth. I think Marcus Jones might be a higher overall. I'm not sure, though. Tyrone May is a 73 overall. I keep almost saying 75, but yeah, he's also a 73. Definitely a good player. I wish we got dev traits on those three players, but they're good overalls. And then I took this Derek Still guy. He's meh, 69 overall, which nice, but no dev trait. And I can't remember where I simmed it. I don't think I made this pick, but the CPU did really well. Another Merriweather. Pat Merriweather at a 74 overall. Really good pass blocker, so we'll take that. Could start over Cole Strange, but I might prefer to keep Cole Strange starting. I don't know. And then it picked a 74 overall hidden dev slot receiver. Maybe we should start him. The CPU fucking carrying out here. What? We're gonna have some tough decisions to make at receiver. We have like three options to start as the third receiver. It might have to be Whitfield because he is a slot, unless we want to play Juju in the slot or something. I don't know, but that was a really, really good draft. That might be one of the best off seasons I've ever had in a Madden rebuild. That was fucking insane. I might trade one of these receivers away just because we have so goddamn many. If somebody wants one, I mean, maybe they don't have any interest. Oh my, what the fuck is this receiving core? The Vikings have Justin Jefferson, DeAndre Hopkins, Michael Thomas, and Jordan Addison. What? That's fucking unfair. Okay, there isn't really anybody that could use like one of our depth receivers, honestly, unless I were to trade Tyquan Thornton, but nah, he's the same overall, so nothing we can really do there. We're just gonna have an absurd amount of depth. Who are we even gonna cut? Because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 receivers that I want to make the team. Holy shit, dude. Okay, this is low-key one of the most, like, fun teams I've ever built, and it's only year 3. This is just a really deep team. I mean, we have the two younger backups on the offensive line, both rookies. They're both really good players. We have so much depth at receiver. I mean, our superstar dev one isn't even really listed here. He's, like, our 8th best receiver. I want to get him playing time, but I don't really see where we could. Obviously, we just added Justin Herbert, Michael Pittman. Y'all have seen that a few times already, though. And then on defense, our offense definitely looks better. But of course, we made some big additions here, too. I mean, Rashawn Gary, DJ Reader. Peter, Shaq Thompson. Zach Sealer was also just chilling in free agency right now, so I just picked him up. Amazing depth. Like, he could honestly start for us if I wanted him to. This team is just really, really nice. So with that, let's get to the midseason point of year number 3, and hopefully we're doing better than the last 2 years. All right, so at the midseason point of year number 3, we are 6-1, doing very, very well. We have the 6th best scoring offense in the NFL, the 7th best scoring defense in the NFL, so we're doing really well. I'm surprised at 6th and 7th we are 6-1, but we'll definitely take it. I won't complain. What I might complain about is who we have to re-sign. Who is going to be here? Well, quite a few starters, that's for sure. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 starters, and we only have 39 mil to work with. I think the biggest priority here is Matt Judon, though, because he's been our best pass rusher. I mean, Rashawn Gary might pass him up this year, we'll see. But Matt Judon will offer him 2 years, 36.4 mil, and he re-signs. Now, Juju is very interested, so I think we might re-sign him, but we could potentially upgrade in free agency, and I maybe would rather prioritize Christian Barmore. We'll offer him 2 years, 18.6 mil, he re-signs. And then how has Dietrich Wise been this year? Really underrated player in real life? He hasn't really been playing much. Although, 2 sacks in only however many snaps that is, probably less than 200, is pretty good. But, he's older, we can get an overall upgrade there. Tavai's a backup, David Andrews has been kind of ass, and he's old. He is good this year, though. He's been really good. But if we do re-sign him, we'll wait until after the year, after he regresses. So, should I re-sign Juju? We could upgrade there. But I'm worried our cap space will go down after the year, and I'd rather re-sign Juju right now than, like, not have anybody to put at number 2. So we'll re-sign him. He does re-sign. We'll take that. Everyone else here, though, I mean, it's just replaceable players. So with that, let's get to the end of year number 3, and let's see how this team can finish. Can't wait to collapse. All right, well, here we are at the end of year number 3 with an 88 overall team. This team is disgusting. But of course, y'all know what this means. Be sure to like, be sure to subscribe. Again, 500 likes, 75 or 7,000 subs, and I'll do another fantasy draft rebuild thingy. Be an OG of the channel if you want to. If you've made it all the way here, I'm questioning a little bit why you haven't subscribed yet, but fair enough. But this team is so goddamn good. 88 overall already. We still haven't even gotten into the last year yet. I feel like I'm getting better and better at rebuilding as time goes on. This team is really, really good. But in year number 3, is that what year it is? Yeah, it's year 3. We finished 15-2. Only 2 losses on the season. We had the best defense in the NFL, the 5th best offense. Our passing yards per game still weren't great. We're still really run heavy. But if we're going 15-2, I'm fine with that. Justin Herbert, 4,300 yards, 35 touchdowns, only 9 picks. He's done better in simulation for sure, but definitely a very good year. Josh Jacobs with 2,000 yards, 2,034 yards, 5.7 per carry, 24 touchdowns. He's a monster. Michael Pittman led the team with 1,000 yards, only 4 touchdowns though. I feel like they don't give possession receivers enough touchdowns. I don't know why. Jeremiah Whitfield as a rookie, 855 yards and 11 touchdowns. Juju was fine, I guess. Blocking, AJ Vogel was really bad, but Keegan Ruff was really good. So one of our rookie tackles is working out. It's not the one I expected because Vogel was better his rookie year. Ruff was really good this year though. Might look for a replacement for Vogel because we're going to need to get somebody. We might as well like replace the weakest link on our team. We'll see. Shaq Thompson and Juwan Bentley both led the team in tackles with 119. Tackles for loss, 15 for Rashawn Gary led the team. And then sack, 10.5 for Matt Judon, only 9.5 for Rashawn Gary, which is good, but I don't know if that's good enough for the money we're paying him. 6 for DJ Reader, 4.5 for Bentley and Dietrich Wise. And interceptions, 5 for Jonathan Jones, 3 for Jack Jones, 2 for Bentley and Duggar, 1 for a few players. Really, really good team. MVP goes to, of course, a division rival in Josh Allen, Mac Jones at number 2. Why did I know that was going to happen? I literally knew. I said he would win MVP. He was second. That I was close enough. Maybe we should try the Raiders playbook. Gardner Minshew, what the fuck? Desmond Ridder, what is this top 10? Specifically, the top 5 is just hurt. It's like the ultimate just rubbing it in our face. Like, two division rivals in Allen and Gardner Minshew, and then Mac Jones, the player we just traded away. I mean, he wasn't doing that here, and that makes me think I should try out the Raiders playbook. Offensive player of the year obviously goes to Josh Jacobs, 2,000 yards, 24 touchdowns, he was a stud. No other Patriots, though. Defensive player of the year goes to another Raider, yet they still couldn't really do anything. At 7-10, Max Crosby wins that. No Patriots up here, though. Offensive rookie of the year does go to Jeremiah Whitfield. Ooh. If he can get, like, superstar dev, that could be pretty massive. No other Patriots, though, and defensive rookie of the year goes to Antoine Baldwin of the Texans. No Patriots. So, absolutely amazing year. But let's see who we're going to be taking on in the divisional. It's going to be the 10-7 Pittsburgh Steelers. We do have a couple upgrades here, not very important ones. I mean, simulating has been working for us. If it's been working, we'll stick to it. God, our division was crazy. We had 3 teams with 10 or more wins. And the Dolphins weren't awful. They were just 8-9. The Steelers are only an 82 overall here, though, so I can't wait to lose. We have 6 overall on them, 5 wins. But let's see if we can take them down and move on to the conference championship. And we do, 41-24. We kind of destroy them. We don't quite blow them out technically, but we absolutely destroyed them. We have an upgrade here for Josh Jacobs. He's going to be a 99 power back and elusive back. I still hate that he's wearing 18, but I don't really feel like changing it. I'm going to be honest. I'm sorry. But we're going to be once again taking on the Cincinnati Bengals, but this time in the conference championship. I think we beat them in the wild card last year or something. They are still an 84 overall. We are an 88 now, though. So with that, let's just simulate this out and let's see if we can move on to the Super Bowl. And we lose to the Bengals? I mean, they're good in real life, but we're like ridiculous here. God, this game absolutely sucks sometimes. What the hell? I don't know what to do. But the Super Bowl is gonna be 2, I guess, cat teams. The Bengals versus the Panthers. We have an upgrade for Jeremiah Whitfield here. Is this for winning Offensive Rookie of the Year? I guess it is. We'll spend that on slot. Decent little upgrade there, and he does have superstar dev now, which I do think he just got. Yeah, for winning Offensive Rookie of the Year, we will absolutely take that. We're up to an 89 overall, and we got taken out of the playoffs. This game blows. Let's see who wins the Super Bowl. And the Bengals do win 49-38. These have been some ridiculously high scoring Super Bowls. That might be the highest scoring of all time. The Bengals still do win by double digits, though, by 11 points. Wish that could have been us, but Madden Sim is low-key ass. Do we change offensive playbooks, though? That's the big question here. I don't know if I want to risk it, because our offense is, like, it's obviously good, but I feel like that's just because it's, like, so ridiculous on paper. We have a really good run game, but I feel like we could have a run game and a good pass game if we switched playbooks. Should we just go with the cheese one? Should we just go Buccaneers? I feel bad going Buccaneers, but it works. Or maybe it doesn't. They had the worst offense in the NFL. Okay. Well, the Giants had a really good offense. Maybe that'll be better? Question mark? I don't think I've ever tried their offense. Should we? Or is that a mistake? You know what? We'll try it. We'll see what happens. I have literally no clue if it's good or not, but we will try it out. I feel like this could be a mistake. I mean, our offense wasn't bad. I just feel like we should have a better passing game. So what do we need in free agency? I let Dietrich Wise and David Andrews go. So maybe those will be 2 positions we'll look at. Maybe safety, maybe like a really good corner. Let's see what's available. Ooh, Micah Parsons is available. Unfortunately, we have -$8 million to work with. Are there any cuts we could make? No, not really. So I don't think we're gonna be doing much in free agency, unfortunately. I guess we can cut like Derek Still, but that's only $1 million. I wonder if we could trade Dakota Weatherspoon. I mean, that doesn't save any cap space, but maybe a team would be interested just to clear this roster out a little bit. This trade would put your team over the... We already are over the cap. This would save us money. What do you mean? Okay, well, there's nothing I can do here. We'll just have to probably draft a center and maybe a D lineman. Unless one of the guards are good at center. I mean, we have a lot of offensive line depth. Pat Merriweather only goes down 1 overall at center. I guess he can be our band-aid starter. We still might draft one, but that seems good for now. We might honestly be worse this year. We'll see what happens, though. I just didn't know this team would go so broke. I mean, I don't know why I'm surprised we're paying about a billion different players. I mean, we're literally paying Josh Jacobs, Rashawn Gary, Justin Herbert, Mike Onwenu, DJ Reader, Michael Pittman, Mike Gesicki, Shaq Thompson, Kyle Duggar, Juju, Matt Judon, Juwan Bentley, Jonathan Jones, Jabril Peppers, Josh Uche, Christian Barmore. Like, I don't know how we're not more broke. So with that, let's just get to the draft and hopefully we can fill our needs there. Okay, so here in the draft, we have the number 30 overall pick. The Saints have number 1, but let's simulate to our pick and let's see what we want to do because I literally have zero idea. Is this guy, he might legitimately be a top 5 talent. Oh, yep, he definitely is. Okay, this corner looks insane. It seems like they did fix that glitch where some players would just randomly show up as top 5 talents, but that guy, I think they fixed that. I think that guy is actually really good. Do we need corner? But if we can get a really good player, why not get a really good player? He's probably going to be like a 77, 78 overall. Doesn't look like absurd, but has 4.29 speed, 4.24 at his pro day. Really good vertical jump too. So let's go Jamichael Hyde. He ran a 4.29 at 6'2", a 4.24 at his pro day at 6'2". Oh my God. But he's 22 years old, out of Ohio State. Let's take him. God damn it. He has normal dev. Okay, well, at the very least, he'll be a good overall player. So we'll take that. I've been getting the worst dev traits in this rebuild though, at least the last 2 years. And here I either want to go with a defensive lineman or, the good D linemen are gone. Unless this guy's good, Tyquan Gordon. Ooh, he could be. Well, ooh, yeah, he might be. We might go Tyquan Gordon, either him or Dexter Vickers, a center. Does he look crazy? I mean, he's not the strongest or the fastest. His power isn't very good, but he does have a lot of A ratings and he's a low injury player, which is a good sign usually. But if I had to guess, who would I say has a better chance to be a starter? Gordon, it is harder to find higher overall D linemen than it is to find higher overall linemen. So I think we're gonna go Dexter Vickers. He's 6'2", 315, 22 years old, out of UCLA. Are we gonna take him? What are our pick? Would he still be there at the end of the third round? I don't think so. Is there another compromise if he's gone? Maybe Chris Daniels? That's maybe what we'll do. If he's gone, we might go Chris Daniels or Rob Carter looks good too. Let's take Tyquan Gordon. He's 6'6", 272, 21 years old, out of Florida. Decent strength, good speed for a bigger, I mean, he's not that big, but a pretty big guy. I like the A awareness. That's the main thing I like about him. Good power moves, apparently. Hopefully good pursuit, good tackle. Let's take him. Another normal dev, but he should be a decent overall. We'll see. I'm just getting the worst dev traits out here though. What the hell, dude? And the center is gone. The other guard is gone, but Rob Carter's here. Oh, he's not that good. Yeah. Well, he has good finesse, maybe good run block, but he's just not very strong. And he looks good enough. We'll take him. Yeah, of course he has hidden dev. Why couldn't the corner have had hidden dev or something? Why is it the backup lineman? Whatever. We'll take it. It's fine. Let's just simulate the rest out and let's see how the CPU can do. Before I do that, is there anything that we need that I'm forgetting? I mean, it's probably too late now, but no, we took a D lineman. We took an offensive lineman. We took that really good corner. Could look for a safety, but I doubt there's going to be anybody that good here. Oh my God, the safeties keep getting slower. What the hell? Okay, we'll just simulate this out. I hate it here. Ooh. Okay, there are some weird things here. Jamichael Hyde is not as good as I thought he would be. I thought he would be at least a 77, maybe a 78, maybe even better, but he's only a 76. I mean, I knew his ratings weren't crazy. I just thought he would be faster. I mean, I feel like a 4.29/4.24 is better than 95 speed, 90 excel. To me, that's like a 4.31 or 4.32. I don't know. Either way, he's a good enough player. I just don't know how much playing time he's gonna get. Tyquan Gordon is good and was probably the right pick for multiple reasons. I mean, he's just good in general, but the lineman that pick made us take is really good. I mean, by the logic of Jamichael Hyde being a top 5 talent, Rob Carter pretty much is too, at a 76 overall. I mean, we got tied for the 5th best player in the 3rd round. That's kind of crazy. And then this D lineman the CPU took, Melo Cooper, is a good player too. He's a massive nose tackle, 6'3", 355, 98 strength. Don't know how much he's gonna see the field at all, but looks like a good player. And then not much else, but I mean, if the players we took had dev traits, there's nothing I can really do about that, but if they had dev traits, this could have been the best I've ever drafted in a rebuild before. Like, this has been crazy. All right, we're making some maybe goofy trades here. I don't know how realistic this is anymore, but we're doing it. We're trading Tyquan Thornton, Colby Parkinson, and Josh Uche to the Falcons for a first round pick. And I'm planning on flipping this first round pick for another player. We'll see. I mean, obviously I want to do something with it. Just what I want to do is kind of the question. I haven't really thought that far ahead, to be honest. All right, in here we're going to be trading Merriweather, the backup guard, not the receiver, and a first round pick to the Bears for Mr. Ed Oliver. It wouldn't quite be a Brandon the Simp rebuild without Ed Oliver. We get him almost all the time. Not so much anymore because the Bills did extend him in real life, but we're making it happen here. So he's obviously going to be a defensive end for us. We did kind of give up a lot for him. I mean, we traded Josh Uche, Colby Parkinson, Merriweather, the backup guard, and Tyquan Thornton to get him, which I guess three of those players are backups, so it's not too bad. I definitely think that was a net positive. But here's a look at the team heading into the fourth and final year of the rebuild. We are looking very, very good. I mean, there really isn't a hole here on offense, maybe like interior or just the left side of our line in general, because Vogel was pretty bad last year, but we'll see how it holds up this year. I am concerned because Vogel allowed 14 sacks and it wasn't even a pass heavy offense, but we'll see what happens. We'll see what Carter can do as a rookie. Receiving core is very good. Obviously, Whitfield got superstar for winning offensive rookie of the year. Not that he was amazing, but good enough to win it. Josh Jacobs has literally been playing like the best running back of all time here. Literally broke the rushing touchdown record and almost broke the rushing yards in a season record. Justin Herbert, we'll see what we can get from him. And then on defense, not much has really changed here, except of course we did add Ed Oliver. Should I start Jamichael Hyde? I'm glad we're not the Bills or something, because I would get him and Micah Hyde mixed up all the time. I'll need to rearrange the edge group. I don't want Ed Oliver coming off the edge. Although I guess if this was like the real Patriots, I guess he would. Well, no, not really. So I'll get that all rearranged. Lucas Van Ness was chilling in free agency, so we'll take that with an upgrade too. I honestly thought the Patriots would take him. He's a really good scheme fit. I was surprised when they didn't. But with that, let's get to the end of the fourth and final year and let's see how this team can do. Oh, at least we made the playoffs, but 9-8 with an 87 overall team. I was thinking our offense switching it like ruined it for us, but our offense wasn't even the problem. I mean, it wasn't good, but we had the 24th scoring defense. Yikes. That's the Patriots defense I know and love in this game. It's normally awful, so I was surprised it was actually good last year. Justin Herbert has not been good. 4,000 yards, 30 touchdowns, which again, I feel the need to clarify this every time because there are idiots in the comment section that are like, oh, 30 touchdowns. That would be really good for real life. This guy doesn't know anything. It's not good for Madden. I mean, it's okay, but Justin Herbert is at the level where he should be getting like almost 50 and does at time. 12 interceptions for him. That's not great either. 1,700 yards for Josh Jacobs, 17 touchdowns, 1,000 yards for Michael Pittman. Not much in the receiving game. It's almost like we didn't even change the offensive playbook. Did I fuck up? I might have fucked up. Hold on. Did I do what I think I did? No, I did it. Okay. No, I did it right. I was thinking for a second I accidentally changed the defensive playbook to the Giants, but no. It looks literally identical to what we just had. The Texans with an 81 overall team were better than us at 11 and 6. That's great. Blocking wasn't good. Was our defense good? We had a lot of tackles for loss, a lot of sacks, actually. The addition of Ed Oliver was definitely good. Interceptions, we had a good amount. 3 for Jamichael Hyde as a rookie. He was really good. 7 tackles for loss from the corner position. We'll take that. What the fuck? MVP goes to Joe Burrow. Davis Mills on the Rams at number 3. Mac Jones, of course, just to rub it in my face at number 6. Gardner Minshew at number 7. Or 8. No, 7. Yeah. This is a weird rebuild. Offensive player of the year goes to Lamar. Josh Jacobs at number 2. No other Patriots. Defensive player of the year goes to Josh Allen. No Patriots. Offensive rookie of the year goes to Greg Combs of the Raiders. Defensive rookie of the year goes to Pierre Mann of the Browns. I thought it would be Jamichael Hyde, but he was all the way down at 5. There must have been some really good rookies this year. Normally the fourth year is like our best, but I don't know what went wrong this year. I mean, we had a better, it wasn't a better offense than last year. It was worse, but to be fair, our defense was like, it went from the best in the NFL last year to one of the worst in the NFL this year. You know what? Hefty audible here. We're gonna change both playbooks. Fuck these. This team sucked. We're gonna go the good old classic Tampa Bay on offense. And even though we had a good defense last year, it was terrible this year. What's a good 3-4 defense? I'm gonna use the Bears for 4-3 from now on. Green Bay had a really good defense this year, but God, they just were work for me. They just don't work for me whenever I use them. Same thing with the Raiders' offensive playbook and the Bengals' offensive playbook. Like, it always seems really good, but then I try it out and it's like, oh, you were the worst offense in the NFL. Congratulations, you dumbass. Like, I don't know what to do about that, but we'll try those. We'll probably lose this game anyways. We're going to be taking on the Texans in a playoff blizzard. We have, I think, 7 overall on them after the upgrades. I think we're up to an 88. We should absolutely put them down by the Titanic, just like the people. Rest in peace to them. That was kind of a fucked up thing to say. But I can't wait to lose this game. Let's see if we can somehow get a win against the Texans. Oh my god, I hate this game. This game is so bad. Well, I did all I could, man. I did what I could. I built a really good team. You can only overcome so much, and unfortunately, you can't overcome stupidity, especially the stupidity of EA. But that's gonna be the end for today's rebuild. I feel like I did really, really well. This team is so good on paper. I'm surprised we can afford all of these players. But of course, if you enjoyed today's video, once again, if you haven't for some reason already, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe. It helps out a ton. And plus, it'll recommend more of my banger rebuilds to you. Plus, it'll make you an OG of the channel while you still can be one. Again, 500 likes, that helps out a ton. 7,000 subs, I know we can easily hit it. And of course, let me know what team to do next for a shout out whenever I pick that team. But thank you all so much for watching. And with that, I'll see y'all again in the next video. Goodbye.